to United Methodist Church. So glad that you have taken the time to watch or to listen to the services today. I want to remind you again, the mask. That's your weapon against this virus. At this point, at least, the mask, social distancing, and taking care of yourself. That's what it still is all about in this very unique December Advent of 2020. We have a list here of prayer names, and I want to remind you, if there's someone you want to put on the prayer list, it's okay to call in to the church, and that's good. But we also need, now, we need to know from the person that we're praying about that that's okay, that they want the prayer. And it's a unique time, and everybody's getting worried about everything and anything, so we have to be careful. So having said that, I'm going to begin with a moment of silent prayer. Then I'm going to move into our prayer list. So can we bow our heads in prayer? Our gracious and our loving God, these are very stressful times. Those that are still employed, working at home, they had to change things up, but Lord, they still have jobs. There are some that are still without jobs. There are some that are just struggling to stretch a penny into a dollar to make ends meet. And we know, Almighty God, that each and every one of us feels a different burden, a different anxiety. There are times when I feel much older than what I am. But yet, Lord, you give me up in the mornings. You give me a task to complete. So, Lord, I want to begin by thanking you for the people of this church. Thank you for their prayers. Thank you for their continuous support of the church. Now, Lord, we know a vaccine is out there. We know we might even have it available to some of our frontline people before Christmas. But there's still some logistics that need to be worked out. We just want to get past this and move on. We know that we'll never return to a sense of true normalcy. There's already been studies that have shown that 10 to 20% of the average attendance of a church will not return, even when they can return for live worship. So, Almighty God, there's many things to reconsider. Many new areas of ministry, new possibilities. For some, it's an exciting time. For others, it's a rather depressing time. So, Almighty God, on this day, hear us as we begin to raise up those that are on our prayer list. We begin with the family and friends of Mamie Williams. Reverend Williams was a former district superintendent to this church. She passed away this week. And so we lift up her, we remember her. We ask for her blessing to be upon her and upon her family and friends. We pray for A.J. Cross. Now, this is a friend of the Dean family, and he's had legal bypass surgery. Actually, it happened and took place December 3rd, which is today. We also pray, Almighty God, today for Dennis Murray. Dennis contracted COVID-19, and he's struggling. He's having a very difficult time. Pray for Bill and Linda Allen. These are the cousins of Linda Thompson. They both have COVID. And their son Wade and their daughter-in-law Tara, who have also tested positive for the COVID virus. Cindy Seibert. Cindy had eye surgery on the 20th of November. We pray for Rob Seibert. He had surgery on November 24th. We pray for Julie Thames, recovering from back surgery. We pray for a friend of Karen Eggert, Ed, who's also diagnosed with the COVID virus. We pray for Shirley Wood, who's back home at the Calvert Nursing Center after being hospitalized for a while. Pray for Cindy Seibert's brother-in-law, David Miller, recovering from broken bones after taking several bad falls. We continue to lift up Jerome Scully. Continue to pray for Billy Patriarca. This is a friend of the Burgess family who is recovering from a heart transplant. We continue to pray for Elizabeth Butler and for her college campus. Positivity rate there has recently doubled, but There's an issue across our country and most of all of our college campuses due to the COVID. Let's pray for that as well. Pray for Charlie White as he continues his recovery at home, as well as remembering Corky, who's caring for Charlie. We pray for Bob and Van King. We pray for Karen Eggert's friend Kathy, who's dealing with chemotherapy for cancer. Pray for Linda Thompson's son, Jerry, and his ongoing health struggles. We ask for prayer for Ed Clark as he's facing surgical procedures. We pray for Lauren Hoover, my close friend, who is still at this time still scheduled for open heart surgery on the 17th of December. We continue to pray for Carol Butler. Continue to pray for Johnny Dow. We continue to pray for Sally and Jay Lounsbury. We pray for Betty Brinker. We continue to lift up Linda Bain. Pray for Beverly and Ted Kretzer. We pray for Dan, a friend of Karen Eggert's, as he continues his recovery from surgery. Now, Almighty God, you have heard us share these prayer requests, but there are so many others that are on our hearts. There are so many that are hurting. Sometimes, Lord, we just don't know how much more we can take or what we can do to help. And so, Lord, give us all strength. There are many that are deciding whether to pay the electric bill or put food on the table. The numbers are climbing, Lord. We are in a difficult time, and we need you. There are those, Lord, who question whether you're even involved in this, whether you have abandoned us or not. Lord, we pray to you and we keep the faith. Try to do whatever we can. And so, Almighty God, be with us. Be with us as this season unfolds, as 2020 comes to an end. We're already praying, Lord, that the next calendar year will be better. Hard to imagine, but in just 3 months, Lord, it will be a year that we've been dealing with the COVID, where we've had to stop live worship. And despite the fact that we tried again, Lord, we had to stop again. So we're doing our best. We pray for our country in this time of leadership transition. We pray for those that are carrying around anger and frustration because of racism, oppression. We need to get that resolved as well, Lord. So, Almighty God, we invite you to step in, to get involved, to point us in the direction. So we offer all these prayers in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, my friends, I want to remind you that Sunday we do have our virtual service at 9 a.m. It will be the second Sunday in Advent. And as you can tell, we have one candle burning. Starting Sunday, we'll have two candles burning. We still have the Christ candle burning over here. We're doing our best here at Friendship Church. And all your words of praise and thankfulness have been greatly received, at least by me, Lord. And by me, Lord, I say by me, because I need it for the pick-me-up that I can get through the day. So my friends, keep doing what you're doing, especially praying. Praying. Again, virtuals at 9 o'clock. Next Tuesday will be our second Advent Bible study at 10. Wednesday at 10, Micah and I will do some more music. And then Thursday, a week from now, we will gather again for prayer. But you know, prayer is something we should do at all times. Pray without ceasing, Paul said. Pray when we're driving. Pray when we're just sitting at home. Pray when we see something happening on television or we get some news. Pray. Be so close to God that at any time you can say, Lord, we need help here. All right. So don't forget your mask. Don't forget social distancing. Don't forget to pray. So until next time, may the good Lord bless you. May you feel the presence of the Holy Spirit dwelling in you. And may you know the love, the power, the healing touch of Jesus Christ. Have a great day.